We are going to discuss a very interesting topic today, which is the recent findings in rock art from different parts of the world. As you know, the rock art creations have been long studied from across the world, and those from Europe especially and also from India have been much discussed in the scholarship. But today I am going to tell you about some interesting recent findings from some parts of the world which are not very well known. So let's have a brief look at these paintings from different parts of the world from the prehistoric period, and then we can have a discussion. Today I am going to tell you about the rock art from some rock arts from Saudi Arabia and from South America and also from India. Let's have a look at these specimens. So as you know that for very long period, the rock art, rock paintings from Spain and France, they were supposed to be the oldest, and they have been long studied. But from South America, we have some very old paintings, and these have also been studied and in recent scholarship, but they are not very well known to the general public. So here I am showing you two paintings from a site called Sítio do Meio, that is in Brazil. And these paintings are supposed to be pre-Columbian, and they are dated to 12,500 before present. Now, pre-Columbian is a very long range of chronology. It encompasses the entire history from before the European colonization of South America. So beginning from prehistory to the European colonization, the entire stretch of period is called pre-Columbian. But here we are talking about only the prehistoric period when these paintings were made. So in Brazil, there is a national park, and these paintings are part of the rock sites there, and these rock sites have been preserved at the as the national heritage. And this is one of the sites. There are several other sites in Brazil where these paintings are available. So here you can see two panels. In the panel on the left, you can see a row of standing some structures, and between these rows you can see human beings. So you can see this human being kneeling here with his hand raised. Here also you can see one human being kneeling and his hand raised, and here also a similar thing, and in between there are these standing structures. Here also again you can see one human being, and he's kneeling and his hands are raised, and there are two structures in front of him. And here you can see another human being. He's standing with his arms stretched. And here another person, and there is a bird here. and here also another bird. So when you look at this, it looks like there is some kind of ceremony happening where these standing structures are like they are, these structures have been erected in a row, and these people, these human beings, they are kneeling in front of these structures and they are performing some kind of ceremony. And there are these other people who are watching. And there is also a bird. It may be that the bird has been sacrificed, or it may be the bird has been killed. We don't know. So this entire structure shows a ceremonial, kind of ceremonial outgrowth. And some scholars are of the view that this shows the ritual aspect of prehistoric humans in Colombia, in Brazil. So this shows that even so, in such an ancient period, like in 12,500 BP, human beings used to have some kind of ritualistic practices. They used to observe some kind of ceremonies. And in this short panel, this is actually the picture of a birth taking place. So this is a woman and a child is coming out, and there are two figures standing there and helping the birth. Three, in fact. So there are three figures standing there and they are helping the birth, birth happening. They are helping the delivery of the child. So these types of paintings, even though they belong to such an old period, they show that the human civilization, even in prehistory, used to have some ceremonies, they used to have some rites, and the delivery, child delivery, was sometimes helped by the other people in the group. So obviously the prehistoric society, this society used to live in a group, and they used to help each other in events of childbirth and other types of social happenings. So this is a type of a social profile of a part of the life of the human society in pre-Columbian period in Brazil, Sitio do Meio. And this is a very recent finding. Now, Burzahum is a very old prehistoric site. It is found in Kashmir. And earlier in excavation, Burzahum has thrown up some sites of some burials in which some skeletons have been found. And it has also thrown up some structures and some pottery. So these excavations, excavated materials, they have been very long known and they have been studied. But this, what you are seeing now, this is a very recent finding in Burzahum in Kashmir. And it shows a rock and some paintings on it. So this was discovered a few years ago only. And it is, scholars are of the opinion that this entire area of Burzahum, this was inhabited even in 4600 BC. So they are of the opinion that the paintings also belong to that period. So there are several rock shelters here where these paintings are painted. So if you look at the left side, shows the black and white photograph of these paintings, and the left right hand side shows a sketch of this painting on paper. The sketch has been made by some archaeologists who visited the place. So if you look at the sketch and also the rock on the left side, it shows that there is an antler right in the center of the image, and there is an archer with a bow, an arrow, and he is shooting this antler with his bow and arrow. And there is another person here who is holding a spear. So this is a hunting scene. So hunting of an antler. This one person is shooting bow and arrow at the antler, and another person is shooting shooting the antler with a spear. So hunting is going on, and there is another animal here, maybe a dog. So this shows that during hunting scenes, during hunting exercises, the human beings, the human society used to live in a group, and they used to hunt in a group. So they used to help each other in the hunting, and they also had domesticated the dog. So dog was domesticated by 4600 BC in Kashmir, and they had trained the dog, and the dog used to help them in hunting. So this entire hunting scene tells us a lot about the prehistoric society that existed in Burzahom in Kashmir. On the top of this hunting scene, you see two sun-like figures. There are two suns in the sky. And there has been a lot of debate about why these two suns are there in the sky. So if it was only one sun, then you could say that this hunting took place during daytime. And when the sun was at the zenith, then the hunters went out and they hunted this antler. But there are two suns, and there has been a debate about why two suns are shown, because there cannot be two suns in the sky. So one opinion is that this is the image of the burst of a star in the sky. So when a star cluster bursts, it shows different stars flying away, and scholars have interpreted that it shows that this prehistoric society had perhaps seen an event in the sky where they could see a star bursting, and the flares of the star they saw in the night. So they could they had painted it here. But there is also another explanation possible, because when you look at the black and white painting shows that these two are actually on different frames. So this is actually, this may be a narrative of the hunting. So in the first panel on the right, you have the man throwing his spear and the dog following and the sun in the sky. And then this narrative continues on the left side. And then on the left side, you have the antler and another man shooting his bow and arrow, and the sun is again in the sky. So the sun actually shows the progress of the visual narrative. It actually shows that this hunting scene happened in the daytime when sun was shining in the sky, and this is a narrative. So if you read this narrative from right to left, it shows that first the man with the spear came, the dog following him, and he threw the spear. And then the narrative moves to the left, and it shows that another person with his bow and arrow then shot his arrow at the antler, and the sun was still shining in the sky. So the two suns are actually not the depiction of the burst of a cosmic phenomena, but they actually show the progress of the visual narrative. So in this painting, then, if we look at it from this perspective,